In this video, I'll be covering inbound content inspection. The first thing I'll cover is the overview for the decryption process. The next thing is the requirements that you have for proxy server certificates that you can import into the Firebox. And the last thing we'll cover is how to use these proxy server certificates with the SMTP and HTTPS proxies. As the title here says, content inspection is decryption. That's what we mean whenever we use that term. So if you see inspect anywhere, it means decrypt. And why is this important? Well, you want to protect any web servers or email servers that you're hosting, because if you are not decrypting the connections coming inbound, you can only see potentially IP address or domain information where this stuff is coming from, but you can't actually see any of the contents or data that are being transmitted from that remote client to your server, or anything that they're downloading from your server as well. So it's important to look at the full set of information during these transactions, especially when it comes to email. What kind of attachments are they trying to send in? So very important to have all of this information decrypted. This is an overview of what happens during the inbound content inspection process. In this example, I'm using an HTTPS proxy to do this. Something similar happens with SMTP, but out here on the external side, or the A channel, the remote client is trying to reach our internal web server here on the B channel. The client will have its connection intercepted by the Firebox, which is acting as the web server. And the Firebox will display the web server certificate to these remote clients, just as your internal web server would do if this connection was allowed through something like a packet filter without any kind of decryption happening. And in fact, you can even use your internal server's web server certificate on the Firebox for this purpose, assuming you can get the private key for that certificate. Inbound content inspection is actually a lot easier for the Firebox to deal with, and it's also easier to configure than the outbound content inspection, because on the internal side, the Firebox isn't needing to check anything, and potentially it doesn't even need to encrypt anything on this side of the connection that is configurable. So it's lower load and there's fewer configuration headaches. Plus, the fact that we only need a web server certificate on this side of the connection, and you don't have to worry about deploying anything to any computers. You're using a legitimate web server certificate for these remote clients to see, just as if they were going to a real web server. And what can we do with the proxy server certificate? Well, every Firebox comes with a default one that just has some bogus domain information in it. And this can work for SMTP, because SMTP doesn't necessarily require domain validation. So you might see it work for incoming email, but it's always best to have a legitimate certificate with your company's information in it. If you are hosting web servers, this is certainly not an option. The default certificate will cause anybody trying to connect to your website to receive a certificate error, because the default certificate doesn't have your domain information. So how do we resolve this? Well, you want to get a publicly signed web server certificate, just as you already do for any web servers you're hosting. And again, you can even reuse your existing web server certificates and just load them onto the Firebox. When you go to load them, if you are hosting an SMTP mail server, then that certificate needs to be loaded as the default certificate. It will prompt you for that, but for any other domains you're hosting or any HTTPS related content, you can just load those into any other slots and you give them a custom name, so you can have as many of those as you need for the domains that you're hosting. Now I'm in the Firebox System Manager Certificates window, which you can access from View Certificates or just by clicking this icon right here. I have the proxy server certificate selected. As you can see here, the common name says https.proxy.null. And if I click the details button, You'll be able to see that there is in fact no subject alternative name. If you refer to the certificate basics video, you'll realize that this is a problem for any clients that are trying to do domain validation. Again, this certificate can work for inbound email, but definitely not for inbound web servers. So we'll need to replace it. In order to do that, I will use the import certificate wizard. And I'm going to go through this rather quickly. If you want a more detailed explanation of this wizard, please see the certificate import video. Go ahead and click next. And I want to use the proxy server option for the inbound connections. And here is where I have to make the decision whether I want to load my web server certificate as the default certificate or load this into another slot and give it a custom name. If I'm doing SMTP, then I would need to use the default option. For HTTPS, it doesn't matter. I can use this option as well. It'll work for both HTTPS and SMTP. Since I only have one certificate, I'll just go ahead and do the default one. It is base64. I'll go ahead and select the appropriate certificate. I just have to change the option in the dropdown here. Once I have that selected, the import is complete, and now I will pick the private key for this certificate. Import that, and the import is complete. So I'll go ahead and click finish, and you can see right here the proxy server slot now has my custom web server certificate loaded. Let's take a look at how to configure the inbound SMTP proxies, since this one is easier. So I'm going to use an incoming action. Go ahead and edit that. Under the ESMTP category, there is the Start TLS encryption. Once I select this checkbox, then content inspection is enabled. And that's really all you need to do. You don't have to mess with any of these settings down here because the optional and allowed encryption is the most compatible. And simply by checking this box, it will enable the SMTP proxy to use the proxy server certificate that is currently loaded in the default slot. And that's all you need to do for SMTP. Now let's take a look at what you need to do for an inbound HTTPS proxy. You need to ensure you are using an HTTPS server action because that will have different options for inbound connections. And you can see right here on the content inspection menu, we have a list of domain names, but if we don't define any domain names, the action will simply allow the connections through. And when you see allow within the context of content inspection, this means that it will leave it encrypted on its way to your internal server. So we're not really checking anything inside of those connections to your server at this point. If I just wanted to inspect all domains I'm hosting on my server, I can choose Inspect, which will decrypt the traffic, and then I can choose an HTTP action that I want to use, preferably one that has services enabled, and then I can choose the certificate I'm using. Because I only have the default loaded, that's the only one that's going to show up here, but if I add more proxy server certificates, those will be available for HTTPS in this dropdown. I can also use routing actions here. The policy default just uses the static NAT that's in the to field of the policy, but I can also direct these connections to a totally different IP. If I do have multiple domains hosted on my server and I want to control the actions of each domain independently, then I can either leave this on allow or inspect. It doesn't matter because this is the none matched for the list above, but I'll just leave that on allow for now and make some rules specifically for different domains here. In this example, I will be using the blog.wgtrain.com domain. I can include subdomains if I want to, and in this case I want to be very specific about what I'm inspecting. So I'll choose the inspect action for this. I would choose the appropriate HTTP server action that has whatever services I want applied in it, such as gateway antivirus. And then again, I can choose whichever cert I have loaded for a proxy server that pertains to this domain that I have right here. And if I had a wildcard certificate, then it would include subdomains like this. I can also redirect this traffic somewhere else as need be. But the focus here is really on the certificate and the HTTP proxy action I'm using on the decrypted traffic. I hit OK, I have this rule configured, so anything going to this blog.wgtrain.com will be decrypted. Everything else will not be decrypted. But let's say I want to add another example here. If I do star.wgtrain.com, that'll catch all subdomains within this. I should also point out that these rules only trigger based on domain names, as the text says, so you should never put a slash or any other characters after this. If you were to put a slash or anything else here, that would become a URL, and it would not work. So make sure that you are just ending it in the domain itself. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose Inspect. Again, choose whatever HTTP proxy action is appropriate, and then choose the relevant certificate for this domain. I'll go ahead and click OK. Because this rule is including all subdomains, I really don't need to have this rule anymore. But in theory, I could even go back and change this to say, well, the blog, maybe I'll just leave that encrypted. So this way I can even make exceptions to the decryption for specific subdomains. But I would need to be aware of the order of the rules here, since this rule would have to come higher up in the list, just as it does right now. If this rule was placed above it, then this second rule here would never take effect because this rule would match first. Just as with the firewall policies, you need to ensure that the order of rules is correct. And that covers the HTTPS inbound content inspection configuration. To recap, content inspection is decryption. So wherever you see that inspect action, the encryption is being broken so that we can see what's inside of it. For inbound content inspection, you really only need web server certificates, whether it be for SMTP or HTTPS. For SMTP, when you load that certificate, you need to use the default option during the import wizard, but for HTTPS, you can load as many certificates as you need, and those can go into either the default slot or the custom slot. It doesn't matter. It just comes down to the number of certificates that you have to import. For more information on inbound content inspection, please use the WatchGuard technical search.